G'day! Thought I'd share another of the Wiradjuri stories recorded by Bill Gammage in Narrandra Shire. And this one concerns young love at Mirrool Creek. And the two lovers ran away in the middle of the night. And at once, two guardians of their clan, a phantom dingo and a spotted owl, circled the camp, crying warnings of disaster. The clansmen woke, but fearing the unnatural commotion, lay still until morning, when the two were found missing. For days, the clansmen tracked them relentlessly to a soak in the Colin Ruby Hills, then back, and finally captured them near the creek. They were tried, sentenced to death, and stood face to face around a large tree so that their arms met. Then their wrists were bound together, and they were left to die, united and apart forever. Now, it's kind of shocking that two lovers were put to death for their transgression, but it's a similar story that is told over in Wagga about Pom and Galana and Gobba Gombolin, who met a similar fate for pursuing romantic love. And the moral of the story, as it was explained to me, is to reinforce that arranged marriages were the norm among the Wiradjuri. And there's a similarity, I think, to a play that Shakespeare wrote 400 years ago about Romeo and Juliet, two lovers who die at the end of the play for going against their family's wishes, perhaps, reinforcing that romantic marriage was not the norm and that you did what your family told you to do, formed strategic alliances, property exchange through marriage. And so I think it's similar that across cultures we see a similar tale being told. Thought I'd share. Till next time. Cheers.